This is the Faith Fight Podcast. Our topic today is Seek First the Kingdom. Hello, everyone. Thank you for tuning into this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. My name is Chris Creary, and I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. Thank you for taking time out of your day. I know you could be doing anything else right now, but instead you have chosen to listen to this podcast. So I am grateful for you deciding to spend a portion of your day with me. And I'm praying that this episode blesses you and helps you to grow to who God has called you to be. For those of you listening for the first time, I want to give you a special warm welcome. I'm thankful for you specifically today. And I'm letting you know that this podcast is available on all of the major podcasting apps. It's on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Amazon Music, Audible, iHeartRadio, and it's on CastBox now. So if you use any of those apps to listen to podcasts, just search for the Faith Fight Podcast and you'll be able to find this podcast, subscribe, and get every future episode that I release on a Sunday morning. And also, I have an archive of over 260 episodes that I've been doing for the past 5 years. So if there's anything that is challenging you and you need to find Bible verses to stand on to build your faith, or if you want me to stand in agreement in prayer, you can listen to any one of the past episodes and just go to the different topic titles and download and listen to any one of those episodes. They will encourage you, they will bless you, and they will help you get the answers to the prayers that you are believing God for. So for those returning listeners, I want to thank you as well. Thank you for coming back and listening to the Faith Fight Podcast. But I'm going to ask you to do something. I'm going to ask you to share this podcast with someone else so that they can be blessed by what we talk about today. Hey everyone, just before we get into this episode, I want to let you know about my new podcast. It's called I Made a Podcast, and it's about podcasting. So if you have a podcast already, or if you had the idea to try and start a podcast, then this new show will help you. In this new show, I interview podcasters from around the world, and we talk about how they make a podcast. They go over some of the tools, the tricks, and some of the resources that they use so that we can all learn more about podcasting. So if you're interested in starting a podcast, go check out my new podcast. I'm guaranteeing you that you will learn something new and be encouraged to start your podcast in this year. And if you're looking for new podcasts to listen to, this will be a good way to be introduced to new shows as well. So you can check out my new podcast. It's called I Made a Podcast, available on all of the major podcasts and apps out there. And I made it easy for you. There's a link in the description of this episode that you can go to and directly go to the podcast. So thanks for listening. And now let's get back to the Faith Fight Podcast. All right. So in Matthew chapter 6, Jesus directs us to seek the kingdom and its righteousness first, and then everything else that we need will be added to us. This is a very interesting scripture, and a lot of sermons have been taken from this verse. Does this mean that we shouldn't work towards any wants in our lives? Is it biblical to have desires for a bigger house or a nicer car or for frivolous things? Today, I'm going to share with you how we are to practically live out this verse. First of all, what does it mean to seek first the kingdom and all its righteousness? This means to turn to God first for all your help, to fill your thoughts with His desires, to take His character as a template for your own character, and to serve and obey Him in everything. When you consider these things, you see that it is making God a priority in everything that you do. So here are some verses to meditate on to do this. Joshua 1 verse 8 says, "Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on it day and night so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful." Psalms 1 verse 1 to 3 says, "Blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked, or stand in the way that the sinners take, or sit in the company of mockers, but whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on his law day and night. That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaves does not wither. Whatever they do prospers." Psalms 128 verse 1 to 4 says, "Blessed are all who fear the Lord, who walk in obedience to Him, you will eat the fruit of your labor. Blessings and prosperity will be yours. Your wife will be like a fruitful vine within your house. Your children will be like olive shoots around your table. Yes, this will be the blessing for the man who fears the Lord. Psalms 37 verse 3 to 5 says, "Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and enjoy safe pasture. Take delight in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust in him and he will do this." And Proverbs 3 verses 5 to 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him and he will make your path straight." So these are just some verses that you can meditate on to help you to seek first the kingdom and all its righteousness. But now we're going to talk about what are some hindrances that we need to look out for when living out Matthew 6:33. So in order to live out Matthew 6:33, we have to avoid hindrances or sins that can keep us away from seeking God. And sometimes they can sneak into our lives if we are not diligent. Here are some verses that you can meditate on so that you are aware if you see them in your life. First of all, there's greed. And 1 Timothy 6 verse 10 says, "For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil. Some people, eager for money, have wandered away from the faith and pierced themselves with many griefs." Next, we need to look out for selfishness. Matthew 16 verse 24 says, "Then Jesus said to his disciples, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me." Next, we need to remember that our personal relationship with God takes priority over any ministry work. And I'm going to read Matthew 7 verse 21 to 23. It says, "Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. Many will say to me on that day, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, and in your name drive out demons, and in your name perform miracles? Then I will tell them plainly, I never knew you. Away from me, you evildoers." We also need to watch out for sin. And Isaiah 59 verse 2 says, "But your iniquities have separated you from your God. Your sins have hidden his face from you so that he will not hear." A hindrance from us seeking first the kingdom is also idols in the form of things or people. And I'm going to read Exodus 20 verse 3 to 5 here first. It says, "You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself an image in the form of anything in heaven above, or the earth beneath, or in the waters below. You shall not bow down to them or worship them. For I, the Lord, your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sins of the parents to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me." And then in the New Testament, 1 John 5 verse 21, it says, "Dear children, keep yourself from idols." And finally, a hindrance that we need to look out for that will stop us from seeking first the kingdom is lust. And 1 John 2 verse 16 says, "For everything in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life comes not from the Father, but from the world." So now the question becomes, how do we balance in seeking first the kingdom and still having other good desires to pursue while we are here in the world? First of all, we need to seek God for everything and acknowledge him as the source of everything that we have. James 1 verse 17 says, "Every good and perfect gift comes from above, coming down from the Father of heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows." We also need to remember that God gives us certain things for our enjoyment. So 1 Timothy 6 verse 17, it says, "Command those who are rich in this present world not to be arrogant, nor put their hope in wealth, which is so uncertain, but to put their hope in God, who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment." And Philippians 4 verse 12 to 13, we need to remember that we are secure in God's hands regardless of the situation. And this verse says, "I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all this through him who gives me strength." And we're going to pray right now, concerning Matthew 6:33, so that we can continue to seek first the kingdom and all its righteousness, and thank God and praise Him for all the other things that will be added to us. So I'm going to pray. You can listen and agree with me. And if you're doing anything that requires your direct attention, please keep your eyes open. But you can agree with me in prayer. So Heavenly Father, we just want to say thank you for your amazing love, your grace, and your mercies. And we just boldly and humbly come before your wonderful presence right now. Thank you for Jesus. Thank you for all that you have done for us, Lord. And we pray for a fresh cleansing with the blood of Jesus. I pray that you touch every single person listening from the crown of the head to the soles of their feet with the blood of Jesus. Purify our hearts, O God. If we have sinned in any way, sins of commission and omission, any sin that we have committed, Lord God, I pray that you would cleanse us and purify us. Holy Spirit, show us our faults, show us where we have fallen short so that we may repent and move forward. And I thank you, O God, for the cleansing of the blood of Jesus, that we are in right standing with you right now, Lord God. And see our heart's desire, O God, to seek first your kingdom and all its righteousness. We love you, Lord God, with all our hearts. And I pray, O God, for every single person listening, that they will love you with all their hearts, Lord God. That they will put you first and make you a priority in everything that they do and in every word that they go, Lord God. I give you the praise and the glory, Lord God, that as we start every single day, that we will start with meditation and devotion time with you, Lord God, so that your word will be alive and active in our lives, Lord God, so that we will live by your word and be governed by your word, Lord God, that word will bear fruit in our lives, Lord God, and we will be able to accomplish your purposes, Lord God, through being led by your word, Lord God, because your word says that your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. So as we meditate on your word, pray, and have devotional time with you, I pray that you will speak to us through your word and lead us, O God, so that we may seek first your kingdom and all its righteousness, that you will lead us to those places that we need to be and do the things that we need to do so that we can advance your kingdom, and that everything else that we need will be added unto us once we put you as the priority in our lives, Lord God. I pray for every single person listening, Lord God, that you will give us discernment, Lord God, to recognize when there are hindrances in our lives that may stop us from seeking first your kingdom, Lord God. Help us to recognize when greed is in operation, when selfishness is in operation, O God, when we are too consumed with our work, O God, that we don't have time to spend devotional time with you, Lord God. Help us, O God, to change the things in our lives, Lord God. Where there is any sin in our lives, O God, help us to repent, O God, and change our behavior concerning that sin, Lord God, so that we may not be hindered, O God, in seeking first your kingdom, O God. And if there's any idols in our lives, Lord God, I pray that you will show us, O God. You are the one, O God, who we are supposed to submit to, O God, and be led by you and your spirit, Lord God. So we thank you, Lord God, that we worship and are led by no one and nothing else but you, Lord God. And we give you the praise, O God. And if there is anything that we are lusting for in this world, Lord God, I pray that you would reveal it to every single person listening, Lord God, so that we will, O God, thirst and desire you, Lord God, more than anything else in this world. And I give you the praise, Lord God. And as we continue to go forward every single day, Lord God, help us to remember that you are our source, that you are our supplier, you are our gyra, our provider, O God. And we thank you that all of our needs, whether it is a need or a want, it's all wrapped up in you, Lord God. Because everything that we need, O God, your word says just for us to ask you, O God, and you will give us the things that we need, Lord God. And your word also says that you give us things, O God, for our enjoyment, Lord God. So we thank you, Father God, that anything that we want or anything that we need, we can come to you in prayer and ask you for them, Lord God. And believe that you're a good Father, that you will answer our prayers, Lord God, if it's aligned to your will for our lives, Lord God. And if it's a request, O God, that is in line with what you have for us, Lord God. And in the right time, O God, in the right situation, I thank you that everything that you have destined for us will come to pass in our lives, Lord God. And it will be a blessing to us, Lord God. It will cause us to enjoy, oh God, the blessing that you have given to us, Lord God. And we will give you glory, and it will be a blessing to others, Lord. So I thank you, Father, for hearing our prayer today. Bless every single person listening as we continue to persevere and seek first your kingdom. And I thank you that your will shall be done in our lives and in the lives of every single person listening and connected to us, Lord. In Jesus' name, we thank you and we pray. Amen. So that's it for another episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I hope that you were blessed by this episode. And if it blessed you, you can go on and share it with someone else so that they can listen and be blessed by this episode as well. Now, if you were blessed by this episode, you can go over to Apple Podcasts and subscribe, leave a review. And for those of you who have Android phones, you can subscribe and listen to the podcast on Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, Audible, iHeartRadio, Squadcast, or wherever you find podcasts. Just search for the Faith Fight Podcast and you'll be able to find this podcast and subscribe and get every single new episode that I release on a Sunday morning. And you can start your weeks off right, have some meditation and some quiet time as you listen to the Faith Fight Podcast. So the only thing I have to say now is to remember to put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you'll hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Something good is happening to you today. Be blessed, everyone.